Hello children, how are you all? Hope you all are fine and doing well. My name is Naresh. Welcome to our channel Physics Plaza. Children, today's session we are going to discuss the numericals based on calorimetric concepts. In order to solve the numericals, what are the formulas which we are going to use? Once again, let us recall that. Children, here Q is equal to mc delta T. So this formula we use to calculate the amount of heat energy required, means amount of energy absorbed or rejected. But here condition is that there should be some change in temperature, then only we use it. Next, C is equal to Q by M delta T. What is CD children here? Specific heat capacity. What is specific heat capacity? The amount of energy required to raise the temperature of unit mass of a substance by 1 degree Celsius is called specific heat capacity. Children, so C is equal to Q by M delta T. What are the units of specific heat capacity children? SI units are joule per kg Kelvin, or CJS units are calorie per gram degree Celsius. Calorie per gram degree Celsius. Next, C dash. What is C dash? Heat capacity or thermal capacity. How to define thermal capacity or heat capacity? The amount of heat energy required to raise the temperature of whole body by 1 degree Celsius or 1 Kelvin is called thermal capacity. Children, either we can use C dash is equal to Q by delta T or C dash is equal to M into C to calculate the thermal capacity. Then which one we can? So that we can't say that, because depends in the data given actually. What is the data given? So based on that, if mass and specific heat capacity is given, then you can use this formula to calculate thermal capacity. If not, if amount of heat is given and change in temperature is given, then can go for C dash is equal to Q by delta T. Then what are its SI units? The SI units of thermal capacity are joule per Kelvin, CJS units are calorie per degree Celsius, calorie per degree Celsius. Next, we'll use the concept of principle of calorimetry. Children, according to principle of calorimetry, heat loss by the hot body is equal to heat gain by the cold body, as there is no heat loss to the surroundings or atmosphere. So according to that, M1 C1 delta T1 is equal to M2 C2 delta T2. What is delta T1? The fall in temperature of hot body. What is delta T2? The rise in temperature of cold body. And from this only, after simplification, we got here T is equal to M1 C1 T1 plus M2 C2 T2 by M1 C1 plus M2 C2. What is T here? It is a resultant temperature. Children, it's very important. Two bodies with a different masses, different specific capacities are at a different temperature. When both are added, when both are mixed, when both are brought in contact, then T will be the resultant temperature. So we use this formula to calculate. But sometimes, you know, sometimes the nature of the substance might be same. For suppose like this. So here masses are different, temperatures are different, but specific capacity, here C only, here is C only. So what happens there? Then C term will get cancelled. Then we will get T is equal to M1 T1 plus M2 T2 by M1 plus M2. Chill, I repeat once again. So when you can use this formula to calculate the result temperature, when both bodies with a different nature, when both bodies with a different nature are given, whereas this formula is used to calculate the resultant temperature when both bodies with the same nature. For suppose hot water is mixed with cold water, so the temperature and mass might be different, but water is the same only, nature of the substance is same only. So there you can use T is equal to M1 T1 plus M2 T2 by M1 plus M2. Okay children, please copy it, then we'll start a numerical. Yeah, children, look at first numerical. By imparting heat to a body, its temperature rises by 15 degrees Celsius. Then what is the corresponding rise in temperature on Kelvin scale? So it is given that here is a body. Okay, it is provided some amount of heat, let us say Q, so that the rise in temperature is given 15 degrees Celsius. Then they are asking us to calculate, find the corresponding temperature, corresponding rise in temperature on Kelvin scale. Children, here, so there will be some misconception. There will be some misconception. Some children, what do they do, you know? They will take 15 plus 273, then they will make it as a 288 degrees Celsius they will make. But dear children, this is a wrong concept here actually. Why? Here they are talking about rise in temperature. Look at here, rises by 15 degree Celsius, rises by 15 degree Celsius. Already we have discussed, what is that? The rise in temperature, if T is a rise in delta T, let us say, delta T is a rise in temperature in a Celsius scale, whereas delta capital T is a rise in temperature in a Kelvin scale. So it's very clear that with the last classes, delta T, the rise in temperature in degree Celsius is equal to the rise in temperature in a Kelvin scale. Actually, it's very, very, very important. Very means very much important. Once again, I am saying the rise in temperature in a Celsius scale is equal to the rise in temperature in a Kelvin scale. So according to that, 1 degree Celsius rise in temperature is equal to 1 Kelvin. 1 degree Celsius rise in temperature is equal to 1 Kelvin. Then it is given that 15 degree Celsius rise in temperature. Then what is the corresponding rise in temperature in Kelvin scale? It will be 15 Kelvins. That is, 15 degree Celsius is equal to 15 Kelvins is the answer. Children, here second numerical, look at here. Calculate the heat capacity of a copper vessel of mass 150 grams and the specific capacity is given 410 joule per kg Kelvin. And also they are asking us to calculate how much heat energy will be required to increase the temperature of the vessel in part A from 25 degree Celsius to 35 degree Celsius. Children, the concept is given like this. Here is a copper vessel whose mass is 150 grams. And initially, this copper vessel is at 25 degree Celsius. So, in order to raise its temperature from 25 degree Celsius to 35 degree Celsius, some amount of heat is required, right? So, they are asking us to calculate the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of copper vessel of mass 150 grams from 25 degree Celsius to 35 degree Celsius. Children, whenever we are doing the numerical, the first very, very important thing what we have to do is that let us write the data very clearly. Means what is given, what to be calculated. Let us write here. So, what is given to you children here? Let us write data. What actually given? So, here data is given what? Mass is given. M is equal to 150 grams. The specific capacity is given. C is equal to 410 joule per kg Kelvin. And here initial temperature is 25 degree Celsius, final temperature is 35 degree Celsius. Then what is the change in temperature? 35 minus 25. So here the rise in temperature is given. How much? 35 minus 25, 10 degree Celsius. Then they are asking us to calculate Q. At the same time, they are asking us to calculate even heat capacity also. Heat capacity is what actually? C dash. We need to calculate the C dash. Let us see this. So here we have already direct relation. That is what? C dash is equal to mass into specific heat capacity. Mass into specific heat capacity. So here mass is given how much? 150. Mass is given 150. And C is given how much? 410. So here then you can multiply 150 into 410. You will get one answer. But dear children, that will be wrong. Why? Look at here. Specific heat capacity is given in terms of kg. But here mass is given grams. So, this mass must be converted into kg. It's very, very important. We have to convert. So, 150 grams is equal to how much, children? It is 0.15 kg. You have to convert. Okay, children. Come on. Let us substitute. So, here, instead of 150, what we have to write here? 0.15. So, 0.15 into 410 will be how much? It is 61.5 joule per Kelvin, or we can write joule per degree Celsius. As it is given degree Celsius, let us write, no problem, anything is okay. So this is how we can calculate the heat capacity of a copper vessel. Even they are asking us to calculate the amount of heat required to raise the temperature from 25 degree Celsius to 35 degree Celsius. Children, what is the formula to calculate the heat energy? Q is equal to mc delta T. Mc delta T. Here you can substitute M value directly, C value directly, delta T. Or else Mc already we calculated here. That is thermal capacity. You can substitute this value also directly here. This will be 61.5 into delta T is how much? It is 10 degree Celsius. So it is 61.5 into 10 will be how much, dear children? 615 joules. So this is how we can calculate the thermal capacity and amount of heat required to raise the temperature of copper vessel of mass 150 grams from 25 degrees Celsius to 35 degrees Celsius. Just copy it. Children, look at here, third numerical. A piece of iron of mass 2 kg, here mass is given 2 kg, has heat capacity 966 joule per Kelvin. So, what is the heat energy needed to warm it by 15 degrees Celsius? And even they are asking us to calculate specific heat capacity of the iron also. Children, let us read the data. What is given here? So, data, what is given? So, the question is given, first of all, here is iron of mass 2 kg. Iron of mass 2 kg and its thermal capacity is given 966 joule per Kelvin. Joule per Kelvin. So, they are asking us to calculate what is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of mass of 2 kg by how much it is given? 15 degrees Celsius. 15 degrees Celsius. So, here mass is given. Mass is equal to 2 kg. And change in temperature is given how much, children? Change in temperature is equal to 15 degrees Celsius. And thermal capacity C is equal to 966 joule per Kelvin. Now, we have to calculate Q is equal to how much? And even, sorry, it is C dash, not C. And we have to calculate even C value also. C value also we have to calculate. So, children, look at here. As here, mass is given and thermal capacity is given. So, how thermal capacity and specific capacity are related? Come on. So, C dash is equal to mass into specific heat capacity. C dash is equal to mass into specific heat capacity. So, from this, C is equal to what we can write? C dash by M. C dash by M. So, C dash is equal to given how much it is? 966 by it is mass is 2. So, the answer is 2 fours are, 2 eights are, 2 threes are. So, the specific heat capacity of iron is 483 joule per kg Kelvin. Joule per kg Kelvin. Then, how to calculate the heat energy? Let us solve it. So, Q is equal to, we have formula even MC delta T. You can use, children, here heat can be calculated in two ways. Heat can be calculated in two ways. So, you can use Q is equal to MC delta T formula, or else from the concept of, from the concept of thermal capacity, C dash is equal to Q by delta T. Can be, anything is okay, anything is okay. So, let us take now, let us take this formula. So, from that, Q is equal to what we can write? It is C dash into delta T. C dash is given how much? It is 966. So, it is 966 into delta T is given 15. Delta T is given 15. So, 966 into 15, how much will get? It will be approximately 14,490 joules you will get. Okay, children, this is how we can calculate the specific capacity and the amount of heat energy required to raise the temperature of 2 kg of iron by 15 degrees Celsius. Copy it, children. Yeah, children, next numerical 4. Calculate the amount of heat energy required to raise the temperature of 100 grams of copper from 20 degrees Celsius to 70 degrees Celsius. Children, what is given here? Mass is given. So, let us write the data. It's very, very important, children. So, mass is given 100 grams. M is equal to 100 grams. And temperature, initial temperature is given. It is 20 degrees Celsius. And the final temperature is given. It is 70 degrees Celsius. So, then what is the change in temperature? 70 minus 20. It is 50. So, here delta T is equal to, we got 50 degrees Celsius. And also, specific heat capacity of copper is given. That is C is equal to 390 joule per kg Kelvin. So, they are asking us to calculate the amount of heat energy required. Children, one very important thing again you have to notice. Specific heat capacity is given in terms of kg here. Joule per kg. But here mass is given gram. So, this should be converted into kg. So, that is 0.1 it is kg. 0.1 into kg. Now, so let us calculate the Q value. Children, we know that Q is equal to MC delta T. Q is equal to mc. Children, this formula will be using again and again. Such a very important. Now directly you can substitute the values. Come on children, substitute the values and comment the answer. Yes, you might have tried. Is equal to, so m is 0.1, c is 390, delta t is how much? 50. Delta t is 50. So this will be 0.1 into 390 will be 39 into 50. So it will be how much, dear children? 1950 joules. 1915 joules. This is how we can calculate the amount of heat energy required by using Q is equal to mc delta T. Come on children, copy it. Yes children, next. 1300 joule of heat energy is supplied to raise the temperature of 0.5 kgf. Children, next question number 5. 1300 joules of heat energy is supplied to raise the temperature of 0.5 kg mass. Children, here, 0.5 kg mass. It is given 0.5 kg mass. So, we have to raise the temperature from 20 degrees Celsius to 40 degrees Celsius. For that, we are providing 1300 joule of heat energy. Then, calculate the specific capacity of the lead. So children, what is given here? Mass is given 0.5 kg and initial temperature T1 is given 20 degrees Celsius and final temperature is given 40 degrees Celsius. Even specific capacity is not given, that to be calculated. Q is supplied here. Q is equal to 1300 joule. Then we have to calculate the C value. Children, we know that Q is equal to mc delta T. So from this, what can we write? C is equal to Q by, we can write m into delta T. So this is the formula which we will be using to calculate the specific heat capacity. Now let us substitute the values. Come on children, do it. How much you are going to get? So this will be Q is equal to 1300 by m is given 0.5 into change in temperature, T2 is 40, T1 is 20, then change in temperature will be how much? 40 minus 20, it will be 20 only. So it is a 20. So children, it is 0, 0 cancel, it is 130 by 0.5 into 2 will be 1. So here we got 130, but units, children, heat is mentioned in joule, mass is mentioned in kg. So we will get joule per kg degree Celsius. So this is how we can calculate the specific heat capacity of a given material. Okay children, copy it. Yeah, children, next sixth question. Find the time taken by a 500 watt heater. What it's a 500 watt heater to raise the temperature. Yeah, children, question number 6. Find the time taken by a 500 watt heater to raise the temperature of 50 kg of material from 18 degree Celsius to 38 degree Celsius. Children, till now we have discussed the numericals based on heat capacity and specific capacity. So this is somewhat different, where power also depend, power also involved here. So let us see, here is a block of 50 kg is given, 50 kg is given. So it is heated with a heater, it seems. So let us, it is a heater. Heater, it is a positive, here is a negative. Its power is 500 watt is given. So to raise the temperature from 18 degrees Celsius to 38 degrees Celsius. So in order to raise the temperature of mass 50 kg from 18 degrees Celsius to 38 degrees Celsius, how much time is taken? That to be calculated. So children, then how can we relate power with the heat? So power is nothing but what? The rate of flow of heat, means what we can say, at what rate heat is absorbed or at what rate heat is rejected. So from that concept, we can write P is equal to Q by T. P is equal to Q by T. As P is equal to Q by T, we can write T is equal to Q by P. But Q is not given, but we can calculate how. Q can be written as MC delta T by P. So let us see what is given. Children, here mass is given 50 kg. Mass is given 50 kg and T1 is given 18 degrees Celsius and T2 is given how much, children? 38 degrees Celsius. Then what is the change in temperature? That is rise in temperature. 38 minus 18 will be 20. That is delta T is equal to 20 degrees Celsius. And here power is given. Power is 500 watt. At the same time, the specific capacity of the body of mass 50 kg is given, that is 960 joule per kg Kelvin. Then they are asking us to calculate the time taken. Children, we have here complete data and here is a formula. Just we have to substitute and we have to simplify, then we will get the answer. But children, don't forget that. What are the answer which we are going to get? That we will get in a seconds. Why we will get in seconds? Because it is a watt. So 500 joule per second here. So that what is the answer which we get in seconds, we have to convert into minutes. Children, come on, solve it and comment the answer. Okay? Okay, look at here. So here mass is given how much? 50 into C is equal to 960. Delta T is given 20 by it is 500. Children, 0, 0 cancel, 50, 50 gets cancelled. So it will be 960 into 2 will be how much? 20, it is 12, it is 1920 seconds. So this to be converted into minutes. How? By dividing with the 60. If you divide with the 60, you will get 32 minutes. So children, so the time taken is 32 minutes to raise the temperature from 18 degrees Celsius to 30 degrees Celsius. Copy this. Yeah, children, numerical 7. It is given that, children, here is a liquid in a container. Here is a liquid of mass 4 kg is taken, 4 kg. And in this, we are keeping an electric heater. So, let us suppose it is an electric heater. It is an electric heater of power 600 watt, power 600 watt. And this electric heater takes 100 seconds time. It takes 100 second time to increase the temperature of liquid from 10 degrees Celsius to 15 degrees Celsius. Then they are asking us to calculate the heat capacity and specific heat capacity. Let us read the data, what actually given, children. So here the data, let us write. Mass of the liquid is given, that is M is equal to 4 kg. And here power is given 600 watt. And time is given 100 seconds, time is given, it is 100 seconds, and T1 is 10 degrees Celsius, dear children, T2 is 50 degrees Celsius. Then what is the raising temperature? 15 minus 10, it will be 5 degrees Celsius. So it is delta T is equal to 5 degrees Celsius, delta T is equal to 5 degrees Celsius. Then we need to calculate the specific heat capacity, at the same time, thermal capacity also we need to calculate. Children, from the concept of power, in a previous numerical also we have discussed that P is equal to Q by T. So here Q we can write like this. P is equal to MC delta T by T. So children, here we need to calculate this specific heat capacity, we need to calculate. So let us rewrite the formula for specific heat capacity. So here we will get C is equal to power into time by mass into delta T. Now let us substitute the values. P is given 600, time is given 100, mass is given 4 kg, and delta T is given how much? 5 is given. It is 5. 5 ones are 5, 20 is 4 ones are 4, 5. So 5 into 600 will be 3000 joule per kg Kelvin. Children, 3000 joule per kg Kelvin is the specific heat capacity of the liquid given. Liquid given. Now even they are asking us to calculate the thermal capacity or heat capacity. Children, here how thermal capacity is related to this specific heat capacity? Like this. C dash is equal to mass into specific heat capacity. So here mass is 4 kg, specific heat capacity is 3000 which we got. This will be 12000. 12,000. But dear children, according to the order of magnitude, this can be written like this: 1.2 into 10 power 4 joule per Kelvin. So this is how we can calculate the heat capacity and specific heat capacity. Yeah, children, look at here. 0.5 kg Lehmann squares at a 30 degree Celsius is placed in refrigerator. For suppose children, here is a refrigerator. In this, a bowl is there in which a Lehmann squares is placed, whose mass is 0.5 kg, and initially it is at 30 degree Celsius. And it is given that the refrigerator can remove 30 joule of heat energy in a given second. Then how long will it take to cool the Lehmann squares from 30 degree Celsius to 5 degree Celsius? Children, let us read the data given. What actually given here? Mass of the Lehmann squares is given, that is M is equal to 0.5 kg, and specific heat is given, that is C is equal to 4200 joule per kg Kelvin, and the temperature is given, initial temperature is a 30 degree Celsius to it is 5 degree Celsius. Then what is the change in temperature, dear children? The change in temperature will be 30 minus 5. It will be 25 degree Celsius. 25 degree Celsius. Next, what more is given here? Power is given, of course. So power is given 30 joule per second. Power is equal to given 30 joule per second. Then we need to calculate the time taken. Children, how to do it? So previously we have numerical, the same concept, that is power is equal to heat by time taken. That is power is equal to Q by T, P is equal to Q by T. So Q we can write as a MC delta T by T. So as we need to calculate time taken T, so let us write the formula for time. So here T is equal to MC delta T by P. Now let us substitute the values here. M is given how much? 0.5. C is given 4200. Delta T is 25 degrees. By P is given 30. Children, come on, simplify the answer. How much will get? Come on, try it. Just do that. Do it. Got it? Okay, children. If you can simplify this, you have to get 29 minutes, 10 seconds. 29 minus 10 seconds. So refrigerator will take 29 minutes and 10 seconds to make it cool from 30 degrees Celsius to 5 degrees Celsius. Yeah, children, next. A mass of 50 grams of a certain metal at 150 degrees Celsius is immersed in 100 grams of water at 11 degrees Celsius. Children, it is given that here is in this water is taken, water. In this, they are immersing a metal. So here water temperature is 11 degrees Celsius, whereas the metal temperature is 150 degrees Celsius. Then they are asking us to calculate the specific heat capacity of the metal. Children, here this numerical is based on principle of calorimetry. What is the principle of calorimetry? So according to principle of calorimetry, heat loss by the hot body is equal to heat gain by the cold body, as there is no heat loss to the surroundings. So let us write here. Here what is hot body? Metal. What is cold body? Water. So let us write the data separately here. Children, here is hot body. Here is hot body is a metal. Children, we should be very, very clear about this. And here is cold body. Cold body is water. Cold body is water. So what is the mass of the hot body is given? Mass of the hot body is given, it is 50 grams. And the mass of the water, let us say it is a M2, is given 150 grams. And the metal initially it is at 150 degrees Celsius, whereas water is at 11 degrees Celsius. So when these both are mixed, then what will be the resultant temperature? The final temperature is given 20 degrees Celsius. 20 degrees Celsius is the final temperature. Here children, the specific heat capacity of water is given. Let us say the C2, 4.2 joule per gram Kelvin. Children, look at here the value. specific capacity given in terms of grams. So you no need to convert mass now from grams to kg, no need to convert. So we have to calculate here now specific capacity of the metal we have to calculate. Chala, according to principle of calorimetry, heat lost by hot body is equal to heat gained by cold body. So this will be here m1 c1 delta t1 is equal to m2 c2 delta t2. Chala, what is delta t1 here? The fall in temperature of hot body. What is delta T2? The rise in temperature of cold body. So how can we simplify this? M1, C1. So delta T1 we can write as a T1 minus T is equal to M2, C2 into this will be T minus T2. Children, we have to calculate C1. So let us substitute the values first initially. So M1 is equal to how much? It is 50 into C1 into T1 minus T, that is 150 minus 20 will be how much? It is 130. Let us write directly. M2 is given 150, C2 is given 4.2, and it is 20 minus 11. 20 minus 11 will be how much, dear children? It is 9. 20 minus 11 is 9. So here C1 is equal to 150 into 4.2 into 9 by it is 130 into it is 50. Children, let us simplify this. Come on, do it. Tell me the answer. How much we are going to get? Got it? Solve it. Children, so here we have to get 0.582 joule per, not kg. Here mass is given grams only. Even the specific capacitance are given grams only. So it is joule per gram degree Celsius. So this is how we can calculate the specific heat capacity of a given material by using the concept of principle of calorimetry. Next question. 45 grams of water at 50 degrees Celsius in a beaker cooled when 50 grams of copper at 18 degrees Celsius is added to it. Then calculate the final temperature. Children, here as water temperature at 50 degrees Celsius, it is a hot body. And as a copper temperature at 18 degrees Celsius, it is going to be like a cold body. So here what will happen then when copper is added to the water? Then here water is going to lose heat, whereas copper is going to gain the heat. So here again, according to the principle of calorimetry, children, we are going to use the principle of calorimetry concept. That is what, the heat loss by the hot body is equal to heat gained by the cold body. Then what is the assumption here? As there is no heat loss to the surroundings or any atmosphere. So let us read the data given. Children, here water specific capacity is given in numerical itself and mass is given. So the mass is, it is 45 grams and its temperature is given 50 degrees Celsius. Then here the mass of the copper, let us say it is a M2, is given 50 grams and its temperature is at given 18 degrees Celsius. The children, when these two are mixed, let capital T be the resultant temperature. Then what is the fall of temperature of water here? It will be delta T1 is equal to T1 minus T. That is 50 minus T will be the delta T1. Then what is the rise in temperature of copper here? It will be delta T2 is equal to T minus T2. So it will be T minus 18 degrees, that is a delta T2. So according to the principle of calorimetry, heat lost by the hot body is equal to heat gained by the cold body. So how can we calculate either heat gained or heat lost? So we know Q is equal to MC delta T. Q is equal to MC delta T formula we can use. So this will be here M1 C1 delta T1 is equal to M2 C2 delta T2, or else, dear children, directly you can use the formula. So what is that here? T is equal to M1 C1 T1 plus M2 C2 T2 by, it will be M1 C1 plus M2 C2. So this formula also we can use, because from this again we'll get the same thing. So let us do this. So here M1 is equal to, it is given 45, C1 is given 4.2 into delta T1 will be 50 minus T is equal to 50 into 0.39 into this will be how much, dear children? T minus 18. Come on, let us simplify this. Children, come on, do it. How much you got? So children, here you must get T is equal to 47 degrees Celsius. So this is the resultant temperature. Means 45 grams of water at 50 degrees Celsius is mixed with 50 grams of copper at 80 degrees Celsius. Then what is the final temperature? The final temperature will be 47 degrees Celsius. Yes, children. So here 11th one. 200 grams of hot water at 80 degrees Celsius, and that is 300 grams of cold water at 10 degrees Celsius. Children, here is, let us say, here is cold water of mass. It is given 300 grams. It is at 10 degrees Celsius. Now, here is hot water of mass, 300 grams at 80 degrees Celsius is going to be added. So, when we add 300 grams of hot water at 80 degrees Celsius to the cold water of mass 300 grams at 10 degrees Celsius, then what will be the resultant temperature of the mixture of the water? So children, here let us write, here it is hot water and here is cold water. Hot water and cold water. Children, here again it is a concept of principle of calorimetry. According to principle of calorimetry, heat loss by the hot body is equal to heat gain by the cold body. Children, here hot water mass is given how much? It is 300 gram, and it is at a temperature T1 is equal to how much? 80 degrees Celsius, and the mass of the, sorry, it is given 200. So this will be 300 grams, and its temperature is given how much, dear children? It is at 10 degrees Celsius. Then what about specific capacity? Children, specific capacity is here C only, because the nature of the material is same, the nature of the substance is same. Children, specific heat capacity does not depend on mass. It depends only on nature of the material. So it might be cold water, it might be hot water. It is water only. So nature of the material is same. So here specific heat capacity remains same only. So here, according to the principle of calorimetry, heat loss by hot body equal to heat gain by cold body. So it will be M1C delta T1 is equal to M2C delta T2. Children, why I am writing here left side C only, right side C only? Because the nature of the material is same. So the specific heat capacity also same. So this will get cancelled. So this we can write M1 into, so delta T1, how can we write? We can write as a T1 minus T. So here T is what? T is a resultant temperature. Suppose T is a resultant temperature, then it will be M2 into T minus T2. So let us substitute the values here. M1 is equal to given 200, it is ET minus T, it will be 300 into T minus 10 it is. Children, come on, do it. Got the answer? Yes. Let us check one's answer. So, two zeros, zeros cancel. With the two, just you multiply. This will get 160 minus 2T is equal to 3T minus 30. So, get this 2T this side, get this 30 this side. So, 160 plus 30, how much will get? It is 190 is equal to 3T plus 5, 2T will be how much? It is a 5T. So, T is equal to 190 by 5. Children, 190 by 5 is how much? It is 56. So 36 degrees Celsius is a resultant temperature of the mixture of the hot water and cold water. Yes, children, it is given that the temperature of 600 grams of cold water raises by 15 degrees Celsius. Children, here is a cold water, actually it is cold water, its mass is 600 grams. So after adding 300 grams of hot water at 50 degrees Celsius, so here in one more bowl, let us say here it is a hot water of mass 300 grams, which is at 50 degrees Celsius. When this hot water is added to this cold water of mass 600 grams, its temperature is raised by 15 degrees Celsius. Children, raise in temperature is given. Then what was the initial temperature of the cold water? What was the initial temperature of the cold water? So let us write the data first. Children, here is hot water. Here is hot water and here is a cold water. Let us write the data separately so that we will be having a clarity. So hot water mass is given to children. It is 300 grams and its initial temperature is given 50 degrees Celsius. 50 degrees Celsius. Whereas the mass of the cold body is given 600 grams and its initial temperature to be calculated. But what is given? Raisin temperature is given, that is delta T2 is given. Delta T2 is given how much? 15 degrees Celsius. Children, according to the principle of calorimetry, heat loss by the hot water is equal to heat gain by the cold water. So with that concept, it is M1 C1 delta T1 is equal to M2 C2 delta T2. Children, what is delta T1? The falling temperature of hot water. So here how to calculate delta T1 is equal to T1 minus T. If T be the resultant temperature, T be the, let us say, resultant temperature, then it will be 50 minus T. So let us substitute here. So it will be mass is equal to given how much here? M1 is 300. Children, so here it is a hot water and here is a cold water. Again, the specific capacity depends only on the nature of the material. So the specific capacity for hot water and cold water will be same. So this will be get cancelled. No need to write a C term only here. So delta T1 means how can we write? 50 minus T is equal to M2 is 600 and delta T2 is given how much? 15 is given. Delta T2 is. So 300 ones are 300 twos. So 2 into 15 how much? 30. Children, 50 minus T is equal to 30. Then T is equal to how much? 20 degrees Celsius. But children, this is not answer. This is not answer. It is a resultant temperature of the mixing. When we can mix hot water and cold water, the resultant temperature we calculated. But they are asking us to calculate the initial temperature. Initial temperature. So T2 we have to calculate. Children, here delta T2 is given. So here delta T2 can be written as T minus T2. T minus T2. So delta T2 is given how much? 15. So it is 15. And the resultant temperature we got 20. So this will be 20 minus T2. So here T2 is equal to 20 minus 15. It will be 5 degrees Celsius. Children, once again I am saying you here. They are asking us to calculate the initial temperature. But in order to calculate the initial temperature, first we need to calculate the resultant temperature. After calculating resultant temperature only, we can get the initial temperature of the cold body, that is a cold water. This answer is how much? T2 is equal to 5 degrees Celsius. Yeah, children, here is a last numerical in this session. So what is given? 1 kg of water is contained in a 1.25 kilowatt kettle. So calculate the time taken for the temperature of water to raise from 25 degrees Celsius to 100 degrees Celsius. Children, here it is given. Power of the kettle is given. Power of the kettle. So power of the kettle is given here. 1.25 kilowatt. So as it is in kilowatts, let us convert into watt. That is, we have to multiply with 1000. So 1.25 into 1000 will be how much? It is a 1250 watt is given. And here the mass of the water is given to you children. It is 1 kg. And the initial temperature of the water is given. T1 is equal to 25 degrees Celsius. And T2 is equal to given 100 degrees Celsius. And also it is given specific capacity of water is given how much? It is 4.2 joule per gram Kelvin. 4.2 joule per gram Kelvin. Then what we need to calculate? We need to calculate the what they are asking. They are asking us to calculate the time taken. They are asking us to calculate the time taken. Children, here as specific capacity is given in terms of joule per gram, here mass is given kg. So let us convert into grams it is. So it is 1000 grams it is. It is 1000 grams. Or else you can convert C, that is a 4.2 is there na, that you can convert to kg also. You will get 4200 joule per kg Kelvin. Anything is okay. So children, from the concept of power is equal to Q by T. So here T is equal to what children? Q by P. But how to calculate Q here? Q value is not given. That we have to calculate. How? M C delta T by P. Children, here delta t is equal to how much? T2 is equal to 100, T1 is equal to 25. So delta t is equal to 100 minus 25 will be 75 degrees Celsius. 75 degrees Celsius. So you can substitute. So T is equal to m is equal to how much? So it is 1000 into C value is given 4.2 into it is 75, not 7.5, by power is given, it is 1250. So children, whatever the answer which you get, that will be in seconds only you will get, that you have to convert into minutes. So just simplify this, comment the answer. Okay children, this is what actually today's session. Children, once again I'm saying you, whenever we are doing the numerical, first let us read the data. What is given, what to be calculated, what to be calculated. Once again check whether all values are given in the same system of units or not. If not, we have to convert, especially whenever a specific capacity value is given. Let us check the mass, whether specific capacity it is given in grams, mass also should be in grams only. If a specific capacity is given in kg, mass also should be in kg. So then we will get the perfect answer. Okay children, thank you so much, all the very best.